Quick notes on the distinction between parameters, constants, and variables. Parameters are measurements. They are often symbolized with the Greek alphabet. They are known sometimes, not known sometimes. An example of a known parameter is pi. It is the ratio of a circle's circumference to its diameter, and it's a constant. Another example would be mu, which in statistics represents a population mean. The population mean is very difficult to compute because you would have to sample everyone or everything within the population to do it. So often statisticians approximate that parameter using the variable x bar. X bar represents the sample mean, and that varies depending on which sample you take. Constants are symbolized usually with the beginning of the English alphabet, A, B, C, and so on. And it's just like they sound, they are constant, they don't change. It's a horizontal line on a graph. Variables do change. Examples, x bar, y. dy dx is an example of two variables stacked on top of each other. It represents rate of change, differential, the tangent, and in this case, the top variable, the y, is known as the dependent variable because it depends on the input. It depends on the x. It depends on where you are in the number of. The x in this example is called the independent variable because it does not depend on anything. You just take it as your input. A good way to kind of think about how parameters and variables work together is by looking at the example of this quadratic equation. Below ax squared plus bx plus c equals zero. So this is a quadratic equation set equal to zero. So what we're doing is we're finding the roots of the quadratic. We're finding where the function crosses the x-axis or where the function equals zero. In this case, the general shape of the function is given by the x variable and its degree, the value of its highest exponent, which is 2. So it's square, it is a quadratic, so it's going to be a parabola. However, the parameters a, b, and c, the constants that would be given to us, for example, this might be 3x squared plus 2x plus 1 equals 0. That determines where the parabola is on the number line and where those roots are going to cross the x-axis. And in this particular case, the first parameter A, whether it's positive or negative, is going to determine whether or not the parabola faces up. If A is positive, the parabola is concave up. If A is negative, the parabola is concave down. So the general shape of this quadratic equation is determined by its degree, which is the highest exponent of the variable x, in this case, 2. But the roots and the concavity is actually determined by the parameters A, B, and C. There you have it. Parameters, constants, variables.